town of Galilee. He was sent to a virgin. The girl was engaged to a man named Joseph. He came from the family line of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel greeted her and said,
"The Lord had a special favor. He is with you."
Mary was upset because of the words. She wondered what kind of greeting this could be. But the angel said to her,
"Do not be afraid, Mary. God is very pleased with you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son. You must name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High God. The Lord God will make him a king like his father David of long ago. He will rule forever over his people who came from Jacob's family. His kingdom will never end."
"How can this happen? I am a virgin."
"The Holy Spirit will come to you. The power of the Most High God will cover you. The Holy One that is born will be called the Son of God. Nothing is impossible with God."
"I serve the Lord. May it happen to me just as you said it would." "Yes, my soul gives glory to the Lord. My spirit's delight in God my Savior. He has taken note of me, even though I'm not important. From now on, all people will call me blessed. The Mighty One has done great things for me. His name is holy. He shows his mercy to those who have respect for him. From parent to child down through the years, he has done mighty things with his arm. He has scattered those who are proud in their deepest thoughts. He brought me down rulers from their thrones, but he has lifted up people who are not important. He has filled those who are hungry with good things, but he has sent those who are rich away empty. He has helped the people of Israel who serve him. He has always remembered to be kind to Abraham and his children down through the years. He has done it, and he has said to our people long ago."
Mary and Joseph had promised to get married, but before they started to live together, it became clear that she was going to have a baby. She became pregnant by the power of the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph was a godly man. He did not want to put her to shame and comfort, so he planned to divorce her quietly.
"I don't want to embarrass Mary. She is a good woman. I will break off the engagement and divorce her quietly."
Joseph, son of David, don't be afraid to take Mary home as your wife. The baby inside her is from the Holy Spirit. She is going to have a son. You must give him the name Jesus. That is because he will save his people from their sins."
All this took place to bring about what the Lord had said would happen. He had said to the prophet, "The virgin is going to have a baby. She will give birth to a son, and he will be called Emmanuel. The name Emmanuel means God with us." Joseph woke up. He did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him to do. He took Mary home as his wife, but he did not sleep with her until after she gave birth to the son.
"Come on, girl, we're getting married now."
"Joseph, I knew you would trust me. Thank you."
In those days, Caesar Augustus made a law. It required that lists be made of everyone in the whole Roman world. All went to their own town to be listed. So Joseph went to his also. He went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea. That is where Bethlehem, the town of David, was. Joseph went there because it belonged to the family line of David. He went there with Mary to be listed. Mary was engaged to him. She was expecting a baby.
"Caesar picked a bad time for us to register. My little parents are killing me." "We are almost there. Let's find a place to rest for now, and we can pick up the things later."
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger.
"Behold,
you have a room for me and my pregnant wife to stay at?
No, I'm sorry. All I have is a manger, but the animals are staying here. If you want to stay there, feel free.
Thank you. We will take anything at this point.
While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in the manger, which is in the feeding box for cows, because there was no room for them in the inn. There were shepherds living out in the fields nearby. It was night, and they were looking after the sheep. And the angel of the Lord appeared to them. And the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified, but the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy. It is for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. Here is how you will know I am telling you the truth. You will find a baby wrapped in a strip of cloth and lying in the manger."
Suddenly, a large group of angels from heaven also appeared. They were praising God. They said, "May glory be given to the God in the highest of heaven, and may peace be given to those he is pleased with on earth." The angels left and went into heaven. Then the shepherds said to one another,
"Come, let's go to Bethlehem. Let's go see this thing which has happened. Let's go see the thing that's happened which the Lord has told us about."
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby. The baby was lying in the manger. After the shepherds had seen him, they told everyone. They reported what the angel had said about this child. All heard and were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary kept all these things like a secret treasure in her heart. She thought about them over and over. The shepherds returned. They gave glory to God. Everything they had seen and heard was just as they had been told. After Jesus' birth, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem. They asked, King Herod heard about it. He was very upset. Everyone in Jerusalem was troubled too. So Herod called together all the chief priests of the people. He also called the teachers of the law. He asked them where the Christ was going to be born. They told him in Bethlehem in Judea. The prophet has written, he said, "But you, Bethlehem, and you come out of you, he will be a shepherd of my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said,
"Go, make a careful search for the child. If you find him, bring me a report so I may worship him too."
After the wise men had listened to the king, they went on their way. The star they had seen when they were in the east went away ahead of them. It finally stopped on the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. The wise men went to the house. There they saw the child with his mother Mary. They bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures. They gave him gold, incense, and myrrh. But God warned them in a dream not to go back to Herod, so they returned to their country on a different road. When the wise men had left, Joseph had a dream.
Get up, take the child and his mother and escape to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you to come back. Herod is going to search for the child.
Mary, get up. We have to take the child to Egypt. Herod is going to search for the manger.
Herod realized that the wise men had tricked him, so he became very angry. He gave orders concerning Bethlehem and the area around it. All the boys, 2 years and old, under, were to be killed. After Herod died, Joseph had a dream while he was still in Egypt. In the dream, an angel of the Lord appeared to him. The angel told him to take the child and his mother to the land of Israel, because there those who were trying to kill him are dead. Joseph got up, he took the child and his mother Mary back to the land of Israel. But then he heard that Archelaus was king of Judea. Archelaus was ruling the place of his father Herod. This made Joseph afraid to go there. Warned in a dream, Joseph went back to the land of Galilee instead. There he lived in a town called Nazareth. So what the prophets had said about Jesus came true. They had said he would be called a Nazarene.
Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call.